What was controversial about this particular 1996 movie? And the movie had a lot of things that can be considered objectionable, right? Like a person masturbating, watching a semi-porn film, a celibacy resolve test. But wo sab chhod do, that all is permissible. But something else was controversial, which was the names of the characters and what else. So you have to give us two things that were controversial, the names of the characters and what else. So we got answers from Jatin, Sanya, Aditya.
Hint could Aditya. Be Shivsena went on a field trip with this film.
Aditya says Gunda, Khullam Khulla. Listen, I think
it's like a standard Bombay answer. For any question, it's Gunda.
It is Gunda. So the pounce is closed. Let's
go to Divakar. Divakar has an interesting guess. Go ahead, Divakar.
Prem again. Oof.
Sorry. Yeah.
Yes, Divakar. What was your guess?
I don't know what it was controversial for, but maybe the names, because Boogie Nights was about porn stars, so Dirk Duckler and
some. So your guess is Boogie Nights.
Yeah.
Okay. That's cool.
Listen, I love the answer. Sounds like Prem Agan.
This is the Fardeen Khan one, Prem Agan, no?
Yeah.
Tumhara naam Jay Mehta nahi, Gay Mehta hona chahiye. I'm like, what, dude?
But Chinmay?
Yeah, I'm guessing this is Deepa Mehta's Fire and the portrayal of lesbian characters.
So you're partly correct. It is the Fire. And what are the names of the characters? If you could perhaps guess.
Deepa something.
Okay, so
Sita, Radha, or
it is Sita and Radha, and Fire was one of the first mainstream movies that showed a lesbian relationship.
I won't say it was a mainstream film, it was still a crossover. This is, in fact, before that whole multiplex cinema kind of film, right? Nobody really knew Deepa Mehta as such. I mean, but yeah, Fire, I was not in the country when this film came out. I was in Australia, so I got to see the uncensored version then. I was, again, in my very early 20s. And I was totally blown by the film, because we had never seen two women together. Obviously, you know, over the years, my feelings towards this film has changed, because primarily to do with the circumstances in which they show that the two women have fallen in love. And that is also because of, at times, the stereotype that is associated with lesbians, the fact that they are disinterested or dejected or rejected in relationship with men, and hence they move towards other women, you know. So that's why I have a little bit of problem now with this film. But at that point in time, I think it was great to see something like that, and kudo. And after that, in fact, Nandita Das, I would say, became one of the very foremost voices for the LGBT community. And it was great. It was great. I mean, I'm surprised that even someone like Shabana Azmi went ahead and the scenes that they did, which actresses wouldn't even think today to do it. Insane, like, sort of relationships.
Joshua, you want to add something?
Oh yeah, I just wanted to say that this was the first time, like, protests around this movie, this is one of the first times we see the words Indian and lesbian in the same context, in the same sentence, because there's this huge protest around the Delhi High Court. I think Allahabad, actually, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, so in one of the high courts, there's this huge protest outside where you saw a woman hold up a poster saying Indian and lesbian. So there's this so this movie's, like, beyond its controversy, produced like an iconic.
Completely. I remember, wanting to watch this with my parents, only because I thought this would be a night's coming out vehicle, but which didn't happen. Sanya has something interesting to add.
Just a second.
Hi.
Yes.
Hi, I read somewhere that Fire was sort of based on Lihaf, which is Ishmet Chugdai's, do you guys know about Lihaf?
Yeah.
I feel like, yeah. So it's just that random fact that it was inspired by Lihaf, by Ishmet Chugdai.
Yeah, I suppose the commonality between the two is that in...
I mean, I think people say that it's inspired. It's because they were both lesbian stories. There's not much.
No, I think it is to do with the fact that both lesbian in the both the lead characters in Lihaf and over here get into relationship with other women because of their dissatisfaction with
their relationship
with their husbands. Same as with Lihaf, you know.
I think it's the fact that there's an iconic massage scene that starts with. Yeah. Quilt massage moment.
You know, I always felt and I still feel that I'm for the life of me, I'm like, okay, Lihaf is a great short story, and but we need more representation in books and literature, especially from India when it comes to lesbian relationships. You know, that's my feeling, because I can at least only quote Lihaf or talk about Lihaf and Ruth Vanita to a very large extent.
There's also a big book that we shouldn't forget to mention, which is edited by Ashwini Suktankar.
Yes.
Facing the Mirror. Yes. And it finished 20 years of being published. So it was like looking through books to find lesbian representation. So I think...
Yeah. No, completely, yes.
But we also need to look at, the alternate publishing scene that where you have...
Zuban and...
Yeah, I mean, even Gacy and
other publisher. Yeah.
We host this festival called the Zine Bazaar, which brings together all independent individuals, collectives, etc., who publish their own creation. And you'll be amazed to see the kind of representation and stories being said. I mean, we still look at the very mainstream part of it, but now you have access to social media, you have access, via the internet and things like that.
Yeah.
So, if you dig a little bit more, you'll find so much more representation, and it'll, like, the Indian pop culture scene is fantastic.
While in cinema, demonstrating same-sex relationships wasn't as common, but in literature it was. So in Ismat Chugtai's Lihaf, there is an explicit description of a same-sex relationship. Not explicit, but it's there. And also, Ded Ishkia derives from it quite heavily. Huma Qureshi and Madhuri Dixit. It is even more subtle, so only few people really spoke about it. But yeah, so Huma Qureshi and Madhuri Dixit have an interesting dynamic going on, and Lihaf is alluded to. In fact, some scenes actually are like from the pages of the book. There's like a shadow play and stuff like that. So that's the interesting fact that I wanted to share.